Hello students, our new topic is from the unit number 1, role of a teacher in providing guidance and organization of guidance program in schools. So first of all, we know that a child requires a guidance at each level or in each aspect in the whole life. From beginning to end, he instructs at many levels and he requires guidance program. It may be related to the education, it may be related to the vocation, it may be related to the health, mental health, and so on. And there are so many fields in which a child or a student requires a guidance program. But in the case of school, a teacher plays an important role in the guidance program. The role of a teacher, especially the class teacher, is very major, since it is a teacher who has the maximum contact with the students in the classroom. Sometimes even more than parents who may be working for the major portion of the day, the teacher usually fulfills the functions of parents or guardian as a guide. The first point is needs of the students. It means that every student has different needs as per the individual differences. So this is the duty and the responsibility of the teacher. He should be concerned with the students and problems with the students. The problem may be of any aspect. He should advise him. There are countless occasions in the school routine when a teacher listens to the problem of the child and advises him on the spot. So many times inside the classroom or outside the classroom, the teacher gives advice to the students to solve their problems. He gives information, many information. The second point is maladjustment. He should try to detect the emerging maladjustment of the students. Means the problem which is arising with the student during the lecture and after the lecture, after the classroom. So he always tried to give the solution to the students. Suppose students has the problem related to the selection of the subject. So teacher plays an important role in guiding the students in the selection of the subject. The next point is development. Development is required for the student in different aspects, as the social development, physical development, mental development. So this is the duty and responsibility of the teacher to give the maximum support and guidance to all the students present inside or outside the classroom. Outside the classroom means it is not required. The student may start in any aspect inside the classroom. It may be he has the problem outside the classroom, in the playground, in the laboratory, in the library. So teacher should guide for all-round development of the child. The next point is implementation. According to the need of the child, teacher should implement the right decision. It means that a wrong decision can spoil the student's future and the student's work and many things. A wrong decision can fill the negativity in the student. So there may be many choices in front of the student. So teacher should guide the students to select the right choice out of those. It may be through the reference. Reference means a teacher can refer the students with problems to the school counselor. If teacher is not able to solve the problem of the students, he refer to the counselor. Counselor is the professional. Teacher is not the exact counselor. He plays the role of a counselor inside the classroom or outside the classroom in the teaching learning process. Information. A teacher should share the maximum information with the students regarding that aspect or the problem in which a student is facing the problem. Due to the regular interaction with the students, teachers and good sources of information for the school counselor. Good information should be provided to the students. After that, a student can solve their problems according to their needs, capability, interest, and aptitude. Contact with parents. We know that in today time, most of the schools are organizing the parents teacher meeting in the end or mid of month. This is the reason to interact the parents with the teacher to know about their deficiencies or the problem and the performance of their work. And many information is required for the teacher to know about the student. A teacher cannot render effective guidance work if he is ignorant of his students' needs and developmental pattern. So, knowing the pupil or student is the preliminary in understanding him. He should empathize with the student and so on. So, this is the duty of the teacher as well as of the parents of the child to meet once in the month or contact each other regarding the performance and problem of the child. The next is contact with the students. A teacher must know the weakness and strength of the students. He should understand each and every student and empathize with each student. Empathy may be defined as the capacity of an individual to put himself in the shoes of another. It is the capacity of teacher to feel as a learner feels, to see things as he sees it, so that he may able to grasp clearly the learner's situation in that problem or in that situation. Be warm to each student. A teacher shows his sincere interest in the learner's welfare. Sincerity radiates warmth and gives learners to feel insecure and self-confidence they need. And one more thing, teacher should accept each student completely. Teacher accept each learner regardless of the mental capacity and physical assets or liabilities, social status, religion or color. There should not be the discrimination between the students. The next is testing and evaluation. Testing and evaluation means when a student stuck at any point, teacher gives solution of that problem according to his knowledge and experience. And he may or may not be able to solve the student's problem at his level. I'm talking about the level of the teacher. If he is able to solve the student's problem, that will be fine. Otherwise, he always refer the student to the school or college counselor or the professional counselor to solve his problem. Because the first stage is the guidance program, the second is group guidance, third is the counseling process. It means that a student requires the counseling. This is the next step after the guidance program. Students requires the counseling for that exact problem. So the testing and evaluation is required after giving the exact solution to the student. In teaching learning process, a teacher transacts his lesson according to the need and requirement of the student and as per the curriculum or the syllabus designed for that standard. So this is the duty and suggestion that teacher should provide the notes, the correct notes, not the wrong notes, the correct notes to all the students of the classroom, which is required because a wrong information can give a wrong concept in the mind of the student. So notes are required to all the students. After reading the notes, a student can process the notes, the knowledge provided by the teacher, to make a new knowledge according to him. So notes is required, which gives an idea to the student what he has to learn according to his ability and what is required for his curriculum or to clear the class. Talks. A teacher should guide students in giving a short talk. It means that in talks, every student gives his their ideas, and two or more than two students may have the same kind of problem. So during the discussion, they can find the exact or the similar or choice, many choices of the solution regarding that problem. Foster the development of the positive attitude. Attitude is defined as the persistent disposition of act either positively or negatively towards a person, group, object, situation, or value. Assist each child to improve their study skills. Many of the education problems of the learners arise from the failure to develop effective study skills. This is at present true in all levels, even in school, senior secondary school, and colleges. Learners have a very poor mastery of the five fundamental study skills: location, comprehension, organization, integration, and retention. And talks are required for all the students. So everyone should participate in the talks and should give their suggestions that may be fruitful or not. That is another thing, but they should, each and every student should give their view for that in the discussion. And sometimes the talks or the lectures may be provided by the professional to solve or guide the students at a time. Another one is library. A teacher should guide students in a proper use of library. It means how to read the book, how to issue and return the book, which book is beneficial for which subject. Every teacher guides the students regarding their subject. Every book written by the different authors have the similar meaning, not same, the similar meaning with minute difference. So teachers should guide which book is beneficial and through which a student can get the good content according to his requirement. The next is field of interest of the students. Interest is very vast concept. Every student varies in their interest according to their individual differences. Suppose that one student has interest in studying the mathematics, another has the interest in studying the literature, another may be interested in social science, history, and there are many subjects. So similar that a student has interest according to the situation and requirement, because the interest may change timingly. Time to time, interest may change, but aptitude never changes. Suppose one student has interest in primary section in mathematics, but when he upgrades in the next class, interest, he may lose his interest in mathematics, and he may gain interest in English, Hindi, or science, social science, etc. He may show interest in the vocational field, because in our Indian culture, 11th standard, the admission is given to the student according to the interest and marks obtained in the previous class. So, by keeping in the mind teacher as a guide or providing the guidance program in the school, he should keep one thing in the mind: the guidance should be according to the interest and need of the students. Next is co-curricular activities. For the academic education, all the subjects are required to study in each and every classroom or in the each standard. But co-curricular activities are also assigned along with the curricular activities for his physical and the mental health, because good mental health is also required. Mental health and mental hygiene. Mental health is also required to maintain his body, his mind in a good situation. A weak body or mentally weak student may have problem in many aspects. So co-curricular activities are also required to conduct in the schools, colleges, universities, as per the interest of the students. They may participate in their co-curricular activities as per their interest. Next is reporting. Reporting is required in the last, means a teacher should report about the student to the head of the school. He should report about the student who are experiencing the special difficulties to the parents, to the subordinate, to the school counselor, and many other who may give good suggestion in solving the problem of the student. So reporting is required to finally, we can say these are the duties and this is the role of a teacher in providing a guidance to the students or organization of guidance in schools at in many levels. It means at the primary stage, secondary stage, senior secondary stage, university level, in many subjects, and so on. So I hope you can understand with this video the role of a teacher and the organization of school program, organization of guidance programs in school. Thank you very much.